In this lesson we cover a very common boogie run in all five patterns. We are in the key of G for all three exercises. We start with the pattern number 4 in G. That's the root G, then we have the major third, the fifth, D, the sixth, E, and finally G again, the octave, and back. Higher, pattern 4 as well. The first three notes are the arpeggio tones of the triad, G triad. And we add a 6. Okay, pattern 4 has two octaves, lower octave and a higher octave. The next pattern is pattern number 5, G chord as well. Next pattern, pattern number 1, G as well. Pattern number 2. An octave higher. Still pattern number 2. Pattern number 3. This G. In exercise one, we take one shape, let's say pattern number four, and take it through all three chords of the blues. Pattern number four for the G chord. Same pattern for the C chord, the four chord in the blues. Or the five chord D. Let's move on to pattern number five, starting with G. Your C chord would be here, 10th fret. Next pattern, number one, starting with G. C chord. D chord. C. G chord. C. D. And G. An octave higher, pattern number two, G chord. C. D. And G. Pedal number three, G. C. Higher, pattern number three, G, starting with the high G. C chord. And D. G again. In exercise 2, we try to stay in one area of the neck and change the pattern where the chord changes. We start with pattern number 4 for the G chord. An octave higher. Now the C chord of the blues is a pattern number 2. An octave higher. Still a pattern number 2. Back to G. and back to G. That's your first position, starting with pedal number 4 for your G chord. Now we move up the neck and start with pedal number 5 for the G chord. The C chord is in the pedal number 3, an octave higher. Back to G. Your D chord is a pedal number 2, an octave higher. Back to G. Next position. Starting with a pedal number 1 for the G chord. C chord, pedal number 4. An octave higher. Pedal number 3, an octave higher, and back to G, pedal number 1. Next position, pedal number 2 for the G chord. An octave higher. C chord would be a pedal number 5. And finally, the D chord, pedal number 4. Octave higher. And back to G. Pedal number 2. Your last position, starting with pedal number 3 for the G chord. Octave higher. C chord, pedal number 1. And D chord, pedal number 5. Back to the G chord. In exercise 3, we constantly move up or down the neck while we play along a 12-bar blues. Change your patterns for each measure of the blues. The progression is 4 times G, 2 times C, 2 times G, then D, C, G, and turn around. So let's start with pedal number 4 for the G chord. Then we move up to the next position, or the next pedal, for measure 2. Still G, pedal number 5. Next position, G, pedal number 1. Next position, G pedal number 2, or an octave higher as well. Now we move up and change the chord to the C chord, and this time we have a pedal number 1 for the C chord. Next position, pedal number 2, C chord. Now we start descending the neck and change the chord to G. And we have a pedal number 3 for the G chord. Octave higher. Next position, pedal number 2. G. Then it changes to the D chord. And we have a pedal number 3. Move that down. Pedal number 3 for the C chord. And back. Pedal number 4. Practice this exercise with different starting points and different routes as well.